redeem our captivity. It's so bad. When I say to one of my grandkids, and they like, don't want to move right away, my son and daughter's ready, hurry up. Because they know what's coming. You heard our motto, no! I'm not going to sit here and play with you. Well, please, come on. Will you do this? You and my mama. My mama never treated me like that. Get in here. Now. Right now. St. Mark bell was ringing 6 o'clock. Before that bell stopped ringing, I had to be on my front porch. If I wasn't on the front porch when that bell started ringing, stopped ringing, Burdell was going to turn into vicious feet. That's what my friends called him. Vicious bird. Which he thought of knocking me upside my head wasn't nothing. So how this boy got in trouble, because he got to switch and whip his baby. Oh, my mama and my daddy would have been in jail long. Just for the, I mean, they would have been in jail, under the jail. We'd have been bouncing from Boston home, Boston home. Matter of fact, my sister packed the bag and run away. My mama said, let me help you. And when they left that door, when they came back, I guess they wished they had never come back and never thought about leaving in the first place. Mama looked so bad, so he don't tell y'all that, do you? Mama kept that line. But there's nothing wrong with being faithful. There's nothing wrong with learning that you have to sometimes reestablish your faith.
Amen.
Everybody gets a little weak sometimes. Amen. Tragedy strikes in our lives, and we feel that we are at our wits' end. We don't know what to do. We wonder why it happened to us. Why not somebody else? I truly believe that there are ultimate lessons that the eternal has for us to learn. Let me share this with you very quickly. This is in my reflection and lovely memory of Rabbi Haney Paris, of Rabbi Moshe Ben Abraham. Shalom aleichem kol adat b'nei Yisrael. We're here today in this hour of our sadness and grief for our community, and indeed the Jewish community throughout this country and the world. We're here to pay our respect, to show our love and admiration for a humble giant in the black Jewish world. In honor of our beloved senior rabbi, Haley Paris. We have lost so many of our Israelite giants from our community that my heart and mind are stifled with grief. Chief Rabbi Wilmer Day Matthew, Chief Rabbi Levi Ben Levi, Rabbi Arnold Josiah Ford, Rabbi Yeriyahu Israel, Rabbi Poinsett, Rabbi Tate, Rabbi Yohanan, Rabbi Casey Yeshurin, Rabbi Amatzia Ben Yehuda, Rabbi Brooks, Quen Levi Ben Levi, Mother Louise Elizabeth Daly, Rabbi David Nassim, Rabbi Abba Rubin, Rabbi Joseph Lazarus, Elder Eliyahu, and countless others that are rabbis and elders and Kohanim. Now we have lost one stolen out of Ethiopia in the midst of Nazism and fascism, bound on board a ship bound for America with a family named Paris. So like Moses of biblical times, our Moses was wrapped in a nondescript blanket, lying next to a Torah scroll, also wrapped in a blanket of Ethiopian peasants, and brought to these shores. Now here I am, a man of 62 years, rabbi of 29 years, perhaps making me one of the senior men amongst my colleagues. But I feel like Simba from the Lion King. He put his paw in the print that was left by his father who suffered. All of their footprints, those that went before us, are so large, my footprint cannot fill the void left by our forebears. I shrink when I consider the boldness, the tenacity, the vision, the strength, and the faith of those great men and women that all came before us. They knelt in peerless undergrowth, watching and waiting for just that moment to run toward freedom. Not freedom from physical bondage and chains, but freedom from spiritual and intellectual bondage and chains. Rabbi Halu Paris broke those chains many years ago as he went to the best universities in the Jewish community. He succeeded with honor. Rabbi Paris worked in the Jewish world, but he was always humble. But in the midst of his humility, there rested within his being, within his soul, an understanding of self. Rabbi Paris knew who he was, where he was. He absolutely knew where his inheritance lies. Rabbi Paris was a Hebrew man and a Jew. He was a Jew of the first order of Jews. Rabbi Paris was a scholar, teacher, mentor, spiritual leader, and friend to so many of us here today. Rabbi Paris indeed earned the name Yeshua, Hashem's upright one. But with everything Rabbi Paris accomplished in his life, he never lost his humility. Rabbi Paris never got caught up in himself. Rabbi Paris lies before us to be gathered under his people. But we, his people, stay together as we come together today. One of the sayings that I remember Rabbi Paris for is what he said about young people. He would say, so many young people and so little forgiveness. I pray that his legacy, that we truly learn to forgive one another. Rabbi Paris represented the River Niger to me. If you will bear with me, I say, lo, I am the River Niger. Hear my waters. I wrangle and stream and run. I am totally flexible. I am the River Niger. Hear my waters. My waters are the first sperm of the world. When the earth was but a faceless, whistling embryo, life bursts from my liquid kernels like popcorn. Hear my waters, rushing and popping in muffled finger drum scatter. It is life to hear stretching its limbs in my waters. I am the River Niger. Hear my waters. When the earth mother cracked into continents, I was vomited from the cold belly of the Atlantic to slip slyly into Africa. From the other side of the brow, I see no, hear no, speak no evil, but I know. I am the river Niger. I came to the cloudy Mississippi over keels of incomprehensible woe. I ran away to Henry Hudson under the sails of ragged hope. I am the river Niger, transplanted to Harlem from the Harlem River Drive. Hear me, my children. Hear my waters. I sleep in your veins. I see no, hear no, speak no evil. But I know, and I know that you know that I know. I flow to the ends of your spirit. Hold hands, my children, and I will flow to the ends of the earth. The whole world will hear my words. I am the river Niger. Do not deny me. Do you hear me? Don't deny me. Dear Rabbi Paris, we hear you, and we will never deny you. We will always remember you and your contributions to your people, the house of Israel. Shalom aleichem. Shabbat shalom.